Oof, we need to talk some big black metal out of the Ukraine stat. They are Grave Circles hailing from Vinnytsia out of the Ukraine. And after the release of their debut demo, Tome 1, in 2017, the boys have backed this up with a whopper full-length album, Tome 2, released in 2019. Grave Circles is a project which was banded only in 2016 with an impressive lineup comprising of members from Peste Noire, Crota, and Chaosphere. And what they have created is something very large, extremely dark within Tome 2, loaded with themes around Satanism, death, and the inevitable decay of humans. What a heavy, majestic experience this album is, with some great atmospheric tones, intermittent technical moments showcased by the guitars, and intriguing drum rhythms, agitated blasts, tight bass patterns, and imposing vocals, which did add to the animalistic and monstrous threatening vibe that this album really does have going on. The weighted and intriguing soundscapes were just perfect. The variety within this album, it just truly astounded me. It's just blown me away. Some of these tracks were just straight out brutish, yet managed to maintain that unintentional black metal emotive beauty within the darkness that I talk about often. Others came at me initially more elusive with an ambient flow, even experimenting with some trumpets as heard in the intro to one of my favorite tracks of this album, Predominance. The doom felt was very, very prominently strong within this one. The way the trumpets were played, it just placed me right in the middle of a gloomy funeral procession. The softer guitar interlude within this track was kind amidst the aggression and contemptful mood of this one. The pain and sorrow of those vocals, those lower screams, which mocked the quieter guitars, it felt deliberately disruptive and was a powerful and emotive segue into cutting and staunch guitar riffage and heavy drums. My heart was just totally ripped out of my chest and thrown hard on the floor with this one. It just blew me away. What a masterful darkness that this one carried, complete with haunting and eerie hymns, clean fading in the background. And I had to pick myself up off the floor after this one. Put your headphones on and turn this one right up. When Birth Givers Recognize the Atrocity, what a title, I just love that. The melody here really suckered me in hard, showcased by those fat, stunning and shimmering riffs and heavy sneering riffs as well. Baal's vocals are just incredible and really just tipped off what I love in a black metal style, that's for sure. It demands attention, it's ominous, extremely strong. He just powers through this with a force, dignity, and such opulence. The pace of this track just tore my face off. You know, again, I listened to all of this with headphones on, and it's a must, particularly for your first listen, so please do it. Insane guitars, beats, and overall composition that was crafted together to create a very large, heavy, and beautifully performed track. As much as I love Baal's drumming skills in Peste Noire, it is so great to hear him damaging us with his vocals in this album. He's completely smothering and a huge element to the overall sound. There's no question this album is wonderfully savage, yet there are some really melancholic moments. It feels grief-stricken at times, and other times it's completely evil and fueled with hatred. Tome 2 is gloomy, it's very zealous by the boys, frosty, and I'll liken it to a black metal listen that's lurking in the shadows with some grand and striking lyrics that are very well written. Overall, I have to say this album is executed wonderfully, really, with a production full of sharpness and clarity. Guys, just jump onto Bandcamp, give Tome 2 a listen, and grab yourself a copy while you're there. Please follow Grave Circles on Facebook, they're also on Insta. Total support to the lads of Grave Circles. Guys, please stay around and continue to produce more under this project. It's so deadly and authentically smart black metal, and I want to thank you for it. You've properly given me so much joy with this album. I'm Kelly T, and this has been my Albums of the Week.